Slack Bay, Bruno Dumont comedy. I said that before, comedy, it's no laughing matter. And here is Bruno Dumont to prove it. Early 20th century posh family arrives at the ghastly Egyptian-inspired summer retreat near the coast. They consider the coast is idyllic and they scream about how authentic the locals are, the fishermen and their cockle picking. Little do they know that the locals are anything but friendly and view the visitors with a mixture of distaste and hunger. Meanwhile, two Laurel and Hardy type detectives are attempting to solve a series of disappearances which are plaguing the sand dunes. The poster for this film has a quote which includes the word madcap, to which one might add zany and indeed crazy. Considering the director's back catalogue, and not somebody who is particularly known for this sort of slapstick comedy, it was, I found this gruelling. All the performances are turned up not to, 11, but to the level of absolute carnival, sideshow, clowning, gurning. So you get a really kind of, very, very talented cast who in the past have done some brilliant work doing what can only be described as pantomime clowning. So Fabrice Luchini as the father walking with this kind of strange gait, talking. Everything is delivered at this kind of volume. What's very interesting is that Juliette Binoche, who is never bad in anything, right? Juliette Binoche, who is brilliant in everything, is absolutely terrible in Slack Bay, which I think is a credit to her because it sort of says something about, okay, fine, she is fully committed to this film and its terribleness. It is at 2 hours long.
Yeah, I don't
at
quite least, follow the logic there.
The film is tooth grating and she is every bit as tooth grating as it is.
So how is that? How can that be good?
Well, she's not good. But what
she's committed to it.
She's committed to the film. She's doing. I mean, she's going with. Incidentally, this is just my opinion. I do know people who like Slack Bay. I sat in a screening of it in which a couple of people were laughing, and some, like me, had head in there. I thought it was intolerable. I thought it was. It reminded me of how brilliant Laurel and Hardy are, and how light on their feet they are, and how much their comedy is to do with superb timing, and the whole thing seemed to be conducted at a level in which it was kind of aggressively gurning and shriekingly unpleasant. And I think it's, I remember watching Stonk and thinking, do you have to be German to find Stonk funny? But I didn't watch this and think it was any nationality. I thought it was that you have to be Bruno Dumont to find this funny. And frankly, I don't think even he found it funny either. It's not good.